You got your sexy lips.
Yeah, I got to get to. You know what? I don't be faking this. These my lips. I was born with these lips. When I was little, they used to tell me, "You got some big old lips." And I was all scared and crying all the time because I had these big old beautiful lips. Well, and then when I grew into them with this big butt.
Then that's when
that turned into a whole nother world. All right. Okay, we live. Hold on. Yeah. Yo, yo, yo.
What this up, is, DJ Squirt?
This is DJ Squirt and the sexy James.
Squirt right now.
Here, we're going to change it because I want us to be comfortable. I don't want us to have to go look in other places. So I'm going to put this one here. We're going to bring that camera around here.
Really. Okay.
Because it's only, we got to be comfortable. Right. Okay. See, so now that's better. Okay. That's better. Yeah, that there we go. Better. We can look at either or.
Right.
And we're going to get this together one day. Now, before I used to move the tripod around with my hands, you know. But now we got this remote control system.
Right on.
I'm the bomb. Hold on. Hold on. I want you to tell everybody your name, and I'm about to put you up so they can see it if they don't know.
Okay. James Stephen Hudson, originally from Cleveland, representing Lina Wines and our tasting room. Shout out to everybody at Lina Wines and everybody that's listening right now. The one and only wine of choice in the Cleveland, Ohio area. So black owned.
Look at that peanut butter creamy skin. You were sexy. You were so sexy.
DJ Squirt, you making me blush.
I'm supposed to make you blush. That's what you're here for.
You doggone right.
Okay, that's what I do.
I agree.
Now check this out, James. We in this one now. Check this out, bro. Let me switch that. Hold on.
Okay.
Hold on. Let me switch that.
Alright.
Take that off there. We're gonna put it on me now. See, ain't that hot? That's fly, ain't it? So check this out. Since I've got, I want you to look at this camera.
Okay,
so everybody can see. That's the one they can see. So when I switch them, that's the one we look at.
Okay.
Because Facebook can't see but the one we face.
One face.
Right. Okay, cool. So check this out.
What's up, DJ Squirt?
He is somebody. I'm sorry, y'all. We can't see your comments right now.
We can't?
Because we can't. Normally, when we go through it, we can see their comments, and we will respond and reply to them. So they may get mad if we're not responding. But we can't see your comments because Squirt got this new software in the studio. And it allows me to be hands-free. so I could feel them guns. But check this out. Okay, let's get down. We're going to get down to the get down. Can't wait to get down to the get down.
Get down.
But the real deal is, do you know the rules of my show?
I do.
You've seen it? So you prepared?
I'm prepared.
You ready? So you know what you're getting into?
I'm ready. All right. I know what I'm getting myself into.
Everybody know what's up. Now, the moment that you walked in this door,
mm-hmm.
you belong to me.
I'm yours.
Squirt. Thank you. Ooh, that was easy.
I'm yours.
Should we turn the camera off? We should turn the damn camera off.
Go ahead and breathe in a little. I'm yours. I'm yours.
Ooh, I like that. Rule number one accomplished. Rule number two. I need you to text your wife, girlfriend, side chick, dog, female dog, that y'all broke up.
Whoever.
Get the phone. Come on now. I'm waiting on you.
I'm going.
Okay, go ahead. I'm going to put the camera on you. Let everybody see you.
I'm going.
Cancel that action.
Let me see. We broke up.
Everybody got to put this mostly on you.
We broke up.
There you go. Y'all broke up. All right?
It's over.
Thank you.
Yeah. No. I got a squirt. I got it.
I ain't scared. I carry guns. So I ain't worried about it. I ain't hard to find. UrbanCityRadioStation.com.
Right.
Now. Very good. Good job.
I can see the comments.
Yeah, but not okay. on. Oh, like, right, we okay. can't. Well, you can if you want. You can answer them if you want.
Okay.
Now. Back to me.
Back to squirt.
I love it. Now we got the woman out the way.
Right.
Be all in my possession.
Go.
I'm very, very, very controlling, James.
Are you?
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's good because I am too.
We could go at it.
Right.
But right now, while you mind, you have to satisfy me first.
Okay. Will
See,
do.
I have this thing called a voice fetish.
All right.
Okay. Oh, you sound real good too.
Thank you.
Ooh, hold on. I ain't even got no. I'm loud. Right. I'm loud anyway. It's going to pick regardless. Up anyway. I'm loud. But anyway, I have a voice fetish.
Okay.
And I like to make men, sexy men like yourself.
Okay.
Say my name. Okay, hold on now. I'm going to set the scene for you because I need you to say it how I want to see it so I can feel it.
Okay. All right,
you ready?
Got you.
We're going to put the camera on everybody to see you. Hold on. Hold on. All right. Take that one off. There we go. Now, we're looking at the camera. Pretend that we're on a cabin. We're in a cabin on a hill. Really
cabin
big hill.
On a hill, okay.
It's like 20 feet of snow outside. Okay? We stuck. We can't go nowhere. So we gotta make do for the night. Okay? Mm-hmm. Now, we got a fireplace. We got some Lina Wines.
Lina Wines.
Ooh, see
oh,
that?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I we like got, the way that sounds.
We got some Lina Wines in the house, right?
Yeah.
And we sitting on this bearskin rug, cozy under the fireplace. I ain't got no clothes on.
None.
So, you don't either. But I'm playing hard to get a little bit.
Oh, okay.
So you have to say my name to make me give up them goodies.
Ain't that a
you gotta problem. Say it real sexy, Corey. You ain't give it.
To.
Cause I'm being dominatrix, real. Right? Go ahead.
All right, Facebook Live. This is what we gonna do right now. See, now with the mood that you already set, I gotta say your name in a way that I'm gonna make you want me.
Exactly.
Okay, so first thing I'm gonna do is.
You still sound good, but go ahead.
The first thing I'm gonna do is. I'm gonna make sure I got my pitch and tone right. So I'm gonna say,
I'm gonna say squirt. You mine. You get the goodies, baby. You get the goodies, baby. Thank you.
You already know.
That was hot. That was real hot. I like the way you did that. You should have seen Mike Berry. You know Mike Berry. You know he's like way thug. You know
right,
Berry.
Right, right.
He was like, "Look, squirt, what you gonna do?"
Right.
Look, squirt, what you gonna do?
You got a dilemma. Right?
It was live as hell. It was so good, but that was good too. I like it. I like the way you did
it. I like that.
All right.
You know what?
You're mine right now.
So. I'm going to tell you the truth.
What's up?
Black really don't crack. And it's like, I look all around, see all these beautiful women all the time. Mm-hmm. And we really, really age very well. So
it's the melanin.
Keep taking your care of your skin, too, because yes. You are gorgeous as well.
Oh, thank you. Boy, we about to be in the cabin.
With the snow. We about need to be some in snow, right?
All right, y'all. Done with all my little satisfactions. Let's go ahead. Let's get to the real business here. That was hot. But he is gorgeous. Look at that, y'all. Y'all better check Lina Wines out. What's her address again?
5248 Lee Road, Maple Heights, Ohio, 44137.
That's hot. All right, Lina Wines. Hot. That's what they see on Facebook. So oh, okay. You'll see it in a minute. Okay. But that's hot. So y'all make sure y'all.
Squirt wine, B, because we have over 23 different wines.
Strawberry.
I got a strawberry white Merlot.
Well, we're going to work that out. Okay. We're going to work that out. We're going to schedule that, work that out. And okay. We're going to video it live and we're going to show everybody the process.
Yes, absolutely. On live. I would love to do that.
Yes, we can do that. Yep. So now, check this out, y'all. I believe Urban City Radio Station is about bringing people together, number one. It's about showing people who you are, what you're made of, to be some type of inspiration to someone else.
Absolutely.
So I like to bring real people in this studio that are really doing things in the Sydney community to show that there is some type of hope in this world, unfortunately, to a lot of things that people experience that they think it's not.
Right.
Now, there may be a kid, high school, middle school, that may listen to something that you've experienced and find some type of hope in you because maybe they grew up like that too.
Absolutely.
So I want to start from the ground up with you, boo.
Okay.
Where you from? We're all at. We starting at the bottom.
Okay.
And work our way up. So like maybe you can inspire someone that, you know what I'm saying, that knows you.
Okay. So, well, first of all, I come from a mother and father, and we grew up on Huff till I was around 6 or 7, and then we moved to 133rd and Kane.
Okay.
On a street where, yeah, it was like right off miles. Yeah, off 131st. Okay. But we had a group of guys. I mean, like, it was about 18 of us, and we all grew up together, and it was just beautiful. The third was everything to me. But unfortunately, my father worked all the time.
Right.
And now that I'm a man, I understand. At that point in time, I didn't understand.
Really?
Yeah. Okay. But he worked all the time, so... a lot of my childhood upbringing, he wasn't there for. So I had to learn from my boys. I had to learn from the streets. I had to learn, you know. And a lot of that wasn't good information.
Not always. But it's good you do it wrong to learn your
mistakes. Exactly,
right.
Exactly.
You're good for your kids.
Pitfalls, yep. Exactly. Yep. The pitfalls of life.
Let's take this back to the childhood. There may be a five-year-old somewhere.
Right.
Okay? So how many siblings?
I got one older sister and one younger brother.
Oh, so you're the middle child.
Yep,
that's middle why child. You,
yeah,
you got the good and the
right,
bad.
Right.
You know how to be good and you know how to be bad.
Right. Definitely knew how to do that.
Right. Yeah. Those middle children, I'm a nerd. I read everything.
Okay.
Middle children are usually the most extroverted. Because.
Okay.
They're usually extroverted.
You're right.
Especially growing up as kids because you've seen the older child do stupid stuff and make mistakes and get in trouble. So you knew to avoid that, and you knew saw the younger child where you was like over the younger child in a way. So you kind of look control from above you and below you. You
correct,
get it?
Correct.
So you knew how to put that together and push it out.
I agree with
that's
that.
That's my opinion.
I agree with that.
Okay. But that, from what I read, that's my conclusion to everything. So don't be looking for the books and say where she get that from. I got it from me. Now, if I'm wrong, I'm wrong, but that's what I said.
But you know what? I think it's also a tug at the middle child as well because my older sister was always the oldest, so she got to do stuff that I wanted to do. My younger brother was always the baby, so he got away with stuff that I was doing.
But,
so it was a tug in that middle.
But that gave you the extra to be able to get around.
Exactly.
Because you saw what he couldn't do, you saw how to get around to do it because he couldn't.
Right.
And you saw what she did that you couldn't do, but you saw how to get around to do it
because
that's what you wanted.
Exactly.
Do. That's why I say that.
Yep.
You had the best of both worlds in a way.
Yep.
Not every situation, but, you know. But that explains why you're so extroverted.
Yes.
But that's hot. So, growing up with your brothers and sisters, so like you, I know you said your dad, he was not really there. You kind of were you upset about that over the years? Or
absolutely, because we were very active in sports, And, you know, it was just, you know, it would have meant something to me to have him there. Yeah. And, you know, I carried that resentment and I carried that on my heart for a long, long time. Really? And it was to the point where, you know, I thought my mother was Superwoman. Because she'd be here,
she
there,
was
and everywhere.
Superwoman.
She was.
But she did it for the love of your daddy, too.
You're doggone right,
how
too.
Long were they together? Are they still together?
Technically, no.
Okay, but still.
Married on fact. Right.
But,
and that was the thing. Like I said, when I became a man and I understood different things and I understood the way the world works, he made a sacrifice for us, made a sacrifice for us.
In tune,
it all worked out together. Mm-hmm. But I vowed to myself that I would never, ever, ever let anybody control my destiny in the way I see fit with my kids.
Amen.
So I make sure I'm at everything, anything possible.
The best
so,
you can be. That's
you know,
hot.
Yeah, the best you can be.
That's very good. I've learned that even over these years, statistics always say how people aren't really being there for their kids. It's a lie.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of these young black men are really, really pushing it out
there. Oh, yeah, absolutely.
And half of these men have custody of their kids.
Mm-hmm.
It's the women not doing so well when it comes to these kids. Like,
it's rewarding to see.
Mm-hmm.
Even my daughter plays J.O. volleyball, and it's a lot of men that be there with their daughters.
Yep.
And my son, he plays all three sports. So you're talking about all fathers that coach, all fathers is there. So, you know, as bad as the media portrays black America, especially young black America, that it's good to see a lot of fathers. I mean, a lot of my boys are great fathers.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking about tremendous
fathers. I'm telling
fathers.
You, I meet men, they all, I got my daughter, they are doing very, very, very well.
Yep.
So,
and the thing is, there's no excuses now. I mean, it's to the point where you like, hey, I mean, even with some people I know, hey, your daddy ain't doing nothing for you. Well, guess what? You got your uncle over here.
Exactly.
Guess what?
You
we
can
about
step
to,
in there.
Yeah, exactly. We about to we about to make this happen.
Yeah, and that's awesome, and that is good because I've seen it, and it's really live. It's there, so it's good to see that. All right. So, how was school for you? Let's start with middle school or something.
Right,
like that.
Right. All right. So
I'm
going ahead.
Cups. Go ahead.
Right. Yeah. Let's do that. All right. So. Middle school growing up was rough for me because I started following the knuckleheads because I didn't know any better. I just wanted to be cool. So I'm following the knuckleheads, getting in all type of trouble. And
but you
something.
Learned from it. You learned.
No, I'm going to tell you what changed my life.
I'm listening, boo. We'll
I'm bringing D's home. I'm bringing F's home. But like I
what
said.
What grade was this, though? Like,
now this
high
seven,
school?
Yeah,
okay.
Seventh grade,
okay.
Yeah. So, seventh grade, that, you want to peel that? Switch.
Do this, hook me up. Go on, Mr. Wine. Do that.
All right, so, anyway, I'm doing all this mess, and like I said, my father's working, my mother's working full-time, and, you know, they monitor me, but, you know, I'm still doing what
I'm doing. A little free reign.
Yeah, exactly.
So you have
I'm cutting school, I got me some, you know what I'm saying? I'm acting.
Seventh grade?
Yeah.
Oh, Lord, have mercy.
Right.
Well, a lot of people did that. I get it.
Right.
I didn't know.
Something that changed my life. And I always tell, I told this story at my college graduation.
Okay.
Changed my life. My mother dropped me off. And, you know, I just had hit the superintendent's car with a glue bottle. Right. So they like, we going to spill you. They like, you doing
you
too much.
Here.
Right, yeah. They like, you doing the most. So I think, you know, when I got home, I'm thinking my mother was a disciplinary anyway.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm thinking she's going to discipline. Yeah, hey, absolutely. I'm thinking she's going to discipline me. And nothing. I
Why
come
not?
Home, nothing. She like, I'm tired of, you know, beating you, I'm tired of whooping you, I'm tired of putting you on punishment, I'm tired of everything. So she said, I'm tired, and dropped me off at school that day.
Oh, that is so good.
Oh, that's that green
I'm
apple
sorry,
Reza.
I didn't mean to stop you.
Oh, that's that green apple
Reza. Green apple, and it's,
yes,
it's 12%
envy.
Apple. tired of you.
Yeah, so look, this is what she did. I go into school, you know, I'm like, dang, I just got off a bloody murder. I ain't used to this.
Right.
Man, I look up, I'm in homeroom, I look up, guess who walking guess who walking in that door? My mama. Done took a week off at work, came to every single class with
Saturday
me.
Sat in that desk. Embarrassment.
Man, I'm talking about lunch, everybody was laughing at me.
I followed my daughter to every class and I sat in the desk behind her. I said, you better have more notes than me.
Right. I'm talking about when my teachers knew her on a first name basis. Man, that was the turning point of my life. And trust me, parents, if you want to make a difference in your kids' life, if they cutting up in school, go to their school and sit down with them.
That is so hot.
And you know what? So eighth grade, I straightened up some. And then ninth grade, when I got to high school, John F. Kennedy.
Okay, you went to Kennedy?
Yeah.
Okay.
She said, my mother was like, you ain't going to really enjoy school unless you get involved with school. Mm-hmm. So I was like, yeah, maybe you're right. So I got involved in school and started playing sports.
To you,
yeah, exactly. I had played baseball my entire life. So I played for Garfield my entire life. So when I got to high school, got on the baseball team. It was just beautiful after that. And then I started taking in the school, and then I started liking school. And then, like you said, I'm not an introvert, so when you're talking, so I found my creative niche, and that was a creative niche that I didn't even know I had.
That's hot.
So remember, especially for my young people out here, your creative niche might creative niche might be something that's unlocked and unleashed. Mm-hmm. So what you have to do is you need somebody that loves you to explore that, and you can open it.
Yes.
That's what I'm
talking
about. It
is very important to show your children love. This is the thing that I say a lot of times on my shows. I say, as parents, it's very important to show our children what it feels like to be loved, what it feels like to be corrected,
absolutely,
disciplined, communicated with, accepted, disapproval. Because once they experience that with you, even as babies, when they get older and someone tries to manipulate them, even if they don't know the history, the words, etc., that goes on with that, they're going to know the feeling.
Absolutely.
Sometimes you learn from what you feel before anybody can express those words to you.
I agree. Totally.
Kids learn from feeling because they don't understand all the language in the first place. So by her showing you that love and that attention and paying attention to you and working with you, that made you
all, absolutely, like, straighten up.
You
turn
ain't got
around.
No choice.
Yep. And it's funny because the sacrifice that I didn't know that she made at that time meant everything to me. And coincidentally, she was there when I graduated from college and I handed her my degree. So
that is beautiful.
It was dope. Yeah, it's beautiful. It was real.
So what about your other siblings? Like, were they the perfect kids and you was just a rowdy
one?
Yeah, exactly. I was about to say, right. I can feel it.
They were both Whitney Young. I was at James.
Oh, yeah, that was a
double straight
special school.
Right.
Smart-ass kids.
You can't get in
play.
There, right? And then, you know, that's right when buses started happening.
Ooh.
So my sister got bused to Marshall while I went up the street to Kennedy. So it was like we in the same household. And then my brother got bused to Marshall, but he eventually came back to Kennedy afterwards. But
wow.
Yeah, it was crazy. Hot. That was crazy.
So you close with your brothers and sisters?
Yes, okay. Yeah. And actually, my mother right now is living with me. And it's been...
That's awesome!
Yeah, I mean, I'm talking about a blessing.
Really?
Like, the kids... Oh, man.
Yes,
my son won't even sleep upstairs anymore. He'd be like, Daddy, I'm going down there with Grandma.
Right.
I'm like, okay.
If my daughter, we don't... She at that age, girl, come. You know what I'm saying?
Well, how old is she?
She's 26. So, you know, she want to party, she want to do whatever.
Yeah,
but, basically, she don't see me as mama. She think I'm going to be a babysitter or something. I don't do that. I'm just not getting out learning my life. I don't think so. But I think that if we live together, them kids will be so happy. You know, I get it, so I can imagine.
Yeah, that their grandmother right there, absolutely.
That tells a lot about your heart.
Mm-hmm.
You know how many people put their mama in a nursing home?
Or put their mama out. So this is how it went down. But she told me this when I was younger. Mm-hmm. She said, when I get old, she said, I'm going to stay with, and she's talking about my sister, I'm going to stay with your sister, you, and your brother. She's like, I'm just going to take turns.
Okay.
And it came to fruition because my sister, she lived with my sister for years. So mm-hmm. when my sister moved, she uses a walker, so she couldn't get up and down those stairs.
Right.
So she's like, you know, I'm going to come live with you. I'm like, mm-hmm. all right. Come on, we got mama. It together.
Shouldn't be no problem.
And yeah, it wasn't no problem. And it's, like I said, it's been a blessing.
That is so hot. Mm-hmm, yeah. You're so hot. You're a cool dude. I'm telling you, I've been bringing everyone in here.
That's the Virgos in us.
You know, we're like totally compatible.
What are you?
I'm a Gemini.
I like.
But
no,
I drive y'all crazy.
I was about to say that because one of my main homeboys.
I drive y'all crazy, but.
No, both of my main homeboys are Geminis, but I've had a relationship with Gemini women where we've been cool.
We cool, but that's the best to get me. I witnessed that. Because that chemistry so hard.
Yes.
You better not run off. You dead. Gemini will kill you.
One of my son, my older son, the mm-hmm. one, and one of my sons is in college where I went to college. So mm-hmm. that's been a blessing too. But
oh, yeah, that is right. May I ask how old you are?
I'm 38.
Really?
No, I'm not. I'm 30.
But I said ask.
I'm 39.
Why are you lying to me like that?
I know, because I just be thinking about it, because I'm used to saying 38. I turned 39 September 14th.
I forget.
And
that
I'll be 40 this year. Yep. So I'm thinking about Hawaii. You got a mini skirt? You could go squirt. Come on. You could go. Hawaii, here
you
I come.
You just gonna get a whip out. Boy, bye. You better quit playing. I ain't that old, but I'm saying it ain't gonna change. Hey, okay, back to the interview.
Yes. So, interlude over.
Right. But no, I like to keep this real. I like to keep these conversations in here to get the real information out. As if we sitting in our living room. Remember on Sundays?
Yeah.
You bring the kids, y'all go to mama's house, she cook, brothers and sisters, cousins, everybody, and y'all just talk about everything. So that's what this is for.
And guess what? That doesn't happen anymore in the community, and that's sad because it should happen. And the only time we do it is during holidays now.
Or a funeral.
Yep, exactly. Yep.
But anyway, I think that is hot. So college.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me in college, what type of things did you try as a young man? Number one, it's hard for our young black men because of society.
Absolutely.
You know, totally the black men have it hard with women in the first place. Because a lot of women are putting men on these pedestals that they're not on, that society has not allowed them to be on.
Absolutely.
You have to really, really, really work hard to be successful just in your basic necessities as a black man. That's
absolutely
real. I don't care how many degrees you got. Yep. I don't care how much money you bring in because it's mental.
Yep.
It ain't got nothing to do with that. It's mental. So you have to mentally be strong just to make it.
I totally, totally agree.
Thank you.
Baby, I like beauty and brains.
Thank you, baby. You mad right now? You better
she's
better
smart
me.
And beautiful. She a major key. But see, that's the miseducation of a black man. Because see, how would I know how to be a man if I never was taught the ground work of how to be a man? So then you have to go ahead and you have to learn these things by falling in the pitfalls and getting up and dusting yourself off and keeping God first, because you wouldn't even
you don't
made
have
it.
No type of faith.
And
I don't care if you have faith in a ribbon.
Right.
You gotta have some type
you
of faith.
You better have faith. You don't know right.
So yeah.
Because I'm really, 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 really understanding that all of those things that I went through. I mean, I went through a point in my life where I thought I was a pimp.
That's what you're saying.
Yeah, I mean, I was in college. I mean, everything was is how many chicks James gonna bring home? You know how many?
You know how many people men came in here and said that?
Yeah.
I'm talking men in Cleveland that are prominent that are doing the damn thing. They said DJ Ellery was in here. Ellery, I had an interview with him. That was one of the hottest interviews I've had.
Oh, okay, cool.
He said that he learned in the streets that they the guys, you know, in the community, the pimp rides the wedding, because they thought that's they
yeah that was together. It right.
They taught him to get as many as you can, get whatever you can get from them, and don't trust. He literally said, "Don't trust them bitches."
Right.
They gave him that attitude. So if he had the attitude as a teenager, all the way until he was, he said, late 30s, early 40s. Do you know how many women he damaged?
Yeah, absolutely. I can only imagine how many.
Because he was taught that.
Yeah.
But we got different men in the world now. Y'all could teach these men a little bit something better.
Absolutely.
They look stupid when they talk about pimping now. They be like, shut up.
Yeah,
exactly. You got mama, sisters, and daughters, your damn self.
Feel? Exactly.
And that's what he said, that he realized, wait a minute, what they told me was wrong, because he was watching his mama.
Right.
His sister and his daughters. And he said, oh.
Absolutely. And I even attribute that back to, you know, I didn't even like the way my father was treating my mother. So it was like, here I am. I mean, I got girls coming from Cleveland to West Virginia.
But that's a natural,
and back and forth.
That's a natural desire, is to want that feeling of love. Think about it. I'm a nerd. Check this out. I don't mean to stop you, but I'm going to let you finish that.
All
right. I know I'm so rude. Everybody be like, you stop everybody. It's not what. It's my
station. If you're doing it with education, I like it.
Right. Now, check this out. I read back in the old days. Now, when they're talking about when the world started, you want to talk biochemistry. You want to talk anatomy. The woman's body was made to reproduce and sexually active at the age that they become on their menstrual.
Right.
So you're talking nowadays 9, 10, 11.
Right.
These are feelings. This ain't got nothing to do with what society made around us. Okay? So the woman or the human was designed for those emotions at an early age in the first place.
Correct.
You're supposed to start making kids 9, 10, 11, 12. Society made it pedophilish because they made these rules and these limitations based on money, not caring about the feelings and the emotions that you go through as a human.
Right.
So, when you turn 9, 10, 11, 12, it's natural for you to want to go and stick that girl. You know what I'm saying?
Right, exactly.
American Pie.
Yeah, okay? Right.
You know what I'm saying? But I'm saying, you just want that feeling. It don't matter what's going on around you.
Right.
You know? So, that's natural. Mm-hmm. So, for you to have them girls, that's different. That's natural. Mm-hmm. I try to tell people that. It's a natural feeling.
Yeah. So, even going back to that. So, you know, I had to view my life and say how I'm treating people and what I'm doing. And it's still didn't really register at that point in time.
Mm-hmm.
I just knew that, you know, it felt good. It felt good to me as being. We went college hopping, so me and my brother and my homeboys.
You feel good right now? No, just playing. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Really,
I'm sorry. Go ahead.
But we went college hopping, and we went, you know, so I had girls from all over. And it was at that point in time, because I never was a dude that was a total dog, but at that point of time, the way I was treating people was dog-ish, because, you know, I'd be like, I have somebody come down from Cleveland, which is a 3.5-hour ride, and I'd be like, go back home.
Boy, bye.
Right?
First of all, the key word is she came to you. That's the problem. I ain't driving no 3 hours to see no nigga. No. Okay, you got to come see me.
I was in college, so, I mean, I would have had you down there, square.
Boy, bye.
You would have been on that 77.
Let me tell you something.
Driving that blue car.
I ain't never done it, ever. I was mean at my age when I was younger. My daughter mean, too.
For real?
I was mean. Okay. I mean, I just was mean. But I ain't going to tell you. We ain't going to talk about me. We talking about you. No, for real. But that's amazing, though. But you would do that, and they would leave, and then what?
Yeah, and then, you know, it'd be some repercussions behind it. I might have a crack window, scratch up cars. Oh, I got stories for days. All right,
so what I want to get to.
but let me, before you go there.
Go ahead.
But you know, that's why I think God lets everything happen for a reason.
Yes.
Because it better equip me, and my boys ain't perfect, but you know, I gave them a foundation, and I told them what was right from wrong. You know, I was telling them, and that's another thing. I lied all the time. I lied about girlfriends, and I used to change my sheets. I used to change my pillowcases. Because I had one girl, she wore too much makeup. She was fine, though. All right,
the makeup man is fine.
Right. I know. That's how I learned about Yaki 1B. I brought her to Cleveland one time. She was like... She was so fine. I just wanted to show her off to everybody. So she was like, I need to go to the hair store. I'm like, well, you got to go to your appointment. She was like, well, pick me up some Yakky 1B. I'm like,
you went and bought somebody's hair. Oh, I need you to get mama to take me to pick up my damn hair. I need some hair.
That's when I was in college. That was so silly, right? But that better made me equipped for my boys to tell them, you know, the real and everything. And I said, you know, it's in a man's nature, like you said, to want to be a little promiscuous. Yeah.
It's a natural feeling.
Absolutely. So, chemistry. But what I told them, I said, you got to be honest. You got to take your steps and be honest. Mm-hmm. Because I said, no, nobody deserves to be lied to. So if you want to have multiple girls you date, tell them. The truth. Right, yeah.
Hey, let them, right. You tell me the truth. Oh, right? I only want you on Tuesday. Okay. You gonna pay my light bill too?
Wait,
say
it
again. Tuesdays at 7:30. All
right. What you say? Okay.
Okay. Cause I got somebody on Thursday.
But no, that's the honesty.
I don't do that. I was just playing. Somebody probably gonna call me like, I'm real. I really
like
am
squirt.
Busy.
Squirt, what's up?
Right, I'm really am busy. I don't know. I'm just playing. Go ahead.
But yeah, so it better equip me to, you know, handle them. And, you know, I have a 19-year-old and an 18-year-old. And they're both just fine young gentlemen. And I really, 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 really appreciate and I'm very proud of both of them. And I also have other kids, but we're talking about the natural impact that I made on the 19 and 18.
I got you. Okay.
As far as, especially as far as, you know, how I was with females. So.
I'm looking at you in here telling the truth. See, it's something about sitting somebody down at the table.
Absolutely.
And that's why I did this. Yeah. People were telling me when I started this, don't nobody want to hear that. I don't know. Yes, they do. 40,000 of them want to hear
that. Bam.
Anywho, I say that every show. I don't make right, shit. Bam. I don't care. Anyway, 40,605
right?
In 1 month wanted to hear it.
How about that?
But right. Right. But that's hot. So let me I want to get to a point to see like what kind of things did you try? What made you who you are today? Like as far as when you were in high school, you know, when we were young, you know, we had the employment programs and
yep.
What was your thought process on what you wanted to do as far as work?
Okay, so I was foggy and lost and everything. I mean, I was just going, but you know what helped me out? I had a guidance counselor who took a good interest in me. Mm-hmm. And she got me together with something called Career Beginners. Mm-hmm. And that's when I went on my first college tour. We went to Miami of Ohio. Ooh. Then we went to Ohio State. And we partied. And I'm like, oh, this is live. So my boy comes home in the summer. And he's like, oh, I go to West Virginia State. He was like, man, that's live down there. And he shows me a picture of this chick. So, you know, I'm like going crazy. I'm like, Ma, I'm about to fill out that application. I'm going down there. Right.
So,
and that's a true story. I didn't know what I wanted to do or where I wanted to go.
Okay.
So I filled out the application that summer, got accepted. Mm-hmm. And me and my mother and her Cavalier drove me down there. Now, orientation was that whole week.
Mm-hmm.
We don't get down there till the weekend. So we get down there and, you know, get registered for school. And it was just an awesome feeling. But I didn't know what I wanted to do. But that program, Career Beginners, just... And that's what I was just talking to somebody about.
Mm-hmm.
I hate when people say... College ain't for everybody. You don't even know if college for you or not, because if you never experienced college, you never even stepped foot on a campus. And that's what I want to implement. That's why I have my Hudson Foundation, is getting these kids aware.
I
want to get these kids aware of college. I mean, some kids don't even know or hear about college till they're in 11th and 12th grade. What about the 8th grade? What about the 9th grade?
Mm-hmm.
Let's start exposing these kids to higher education early.
Mm-hmm.
And on top of that, they can decide then, oh, I don't want to go to college. I want to pick up a trade, which is totally fine. I have one son who's not in school who's picking up a trade, and I have one that is in school. So I'm fine with both of them. But let's give them that opportunity. Let's stop limiting people and saying, oh, well, I ain't go to college, or your mama ain't go to college, or, you know, I didn't do this. Or that. So what? let's start shaping the minds of these kids. Yeah, yes. Exactly. Amen. And the only way we're going to do that is by exposing them. Yes. Let's expose them to school. Let's expose them to different opportunities in education. Let's expose them to different technology programs. Expose them to Barber College. Some
and
of my main...
wait till they 25.
Right, exactly. Right. Some of my main homeboys are very successful, that are barbers, that are welders, that are computer programmers. Mm-hmm. And you don't have to go to college, but I got other homeboys that's doctors and lawyers. Mm-hmm. So it's two facets to every side.
Exactly.
And what you really have to do is start exposing these kids at a young age.
That's true. Very, very young. I mean, they can... Do you notice something? I mean, I'm not being funny. I'm not prejudiced at all. I love all people.
Right.
But like, the Koreans... Oh, I need some more? Yeah, give me some more.
I'm trying to take advantage of me.
You know, you did break up with your wife, right?
Yeah, I broke up. It's over. Right.
But anyway, you know, you look at these other cultures. I won't say racist, but other cultures, how they raise their children, they bring them into their restaurants at 3, 4, 5 years old.
Yes.
You see those, I go to them Mr. Heroes, they be 15 years old, ringing me up.
Absolutely.
Picking the food, cooking, come back, like, dang, this little 15-year-old just did all that.
And that's what I'm saying. I'm saying that we as a people, we don't do that. We're so busy trying to cut each other's neck that we don't help each other out.
Exactly.
Like, I mean, I just look at businesses, period, even with our wine company. You'll be surprised how many people or how many black-owned restaurants and bars and everything that's in the surrounding area who don't even support us.
But you know what? You can't worry about who don't.
I don't. Because that's a motivating factor.
You know, and I have it just as hard, especially being a woman. When I came up with this idea, I researched, I did that. Well, who are you doing this with? Me.
Me, right.
Well, how did you get that? I bought it. Mm-hmm. Well, what is it? I made it.
Right.
I researched it. I asked. I paid for it. Right. I do that.
Yep.
Well, they can't fathom. I don't get that. But it's okay, because we're going to keep
right.
rocking.
Exactly. And that actually makes the motivation even that much stronger.
It does, because it makes me want to go
harder. Exactly, yeah.
Now, you see this? It made me go harder.
Yes,
right?
I like that.
But that's hot. All right, let's go back. Okay, so in college, what's your first job? Everybody come here, ask their first job.
Oh, okay, so.
What's your first job? Like Mr. Hero, McDonald's?
My boy, back in high school, 14. There to this day, but I was 14.
You say he's still there?
No, I said it's still
there. Oh, yeah. He tired, body hurt, knees hurt. Go ahead.
He's like, flip one more damn time. Nah. But 14 years old, I begged my mother. I'm like, come on, we can get in. We knew somebody that knew somebody, got in there, and we worked there, and it was just great. So I was 14 years old, and I ain't never looked back, so.
That's hot.
Yeah.
But you learned, I learned a lot. I worked at McDonald's too.
Yeah, absolutely. You learned a whole lot.
And I learned a lot, because when you learn and see that process and then you apply that to different aspects of your life or at different times, you're like, damn.
Right. And what made me really open my eyes, this was a black-owned McDonald's. So that made me, that put entrepreneurship in me. I'm like, man, I like that. It's a lot of profit.
Like, y'all doing good, creating your own thing. That's good. Right?
No, I'm just saying.
I ain't gonna touch
it. Right.
I love McDonald's.
Who knows? That was the thing back in the day. Back in the day, Sunday, my mother used to go pick up my grandmother. We straight to McDonald's. We was like, yes. We'd go shopping with them for 80,000 hours just to get that Happy Meal. Right, yeah. I'll sacrifice my whole Saturday for that McDonald's Happy Meal.
I get it, but that was some incentive to be, you know, and in the family that brought your family together.
Yep,
too.
Absolutely.
Because my grandbaby still, I take him on dates every night all the time. He's 6 now, but Gigi, he like, where?
Where's Gigi at?
Yeah, I take him on little dates. We have our little dates here and there. But,
oh, okay.
So you worked at McDonald's.
I went there, and that was a great time.
Wow. You love the job at Kmart. What'd you do?
I'm nothing. I did everything.
I'm scared to know what you did.
We're gonna skip that job. Right.
Did you date women on your job?
Absolutely.
Oh my God, I couldn't.
A couple of them.
You know, I wouldn't date people on my job.
I mean, because I told you I was horny, I wanted some, so I was like, man, if I can get some in here,
I told you that's all that mattered. Right. It was hormones, that was just part of the human body growth.
So by the time I'm 6, and so my birthday is in September.
Okay.
So September 14th, so that means I started school early. Mm-hmm. So when everybody else was turning 16 and 17, I was turning 15 and 16.
Okay.
So I always was the youngest. Gotcha. Because of my birthday.
Gotcha.
So when it got time for us to graduate, mm-hmm. everybody was 17, 18, and I was 16, 17.
Okay,
so,
okay.
You know, that had an effect on me because people would be like, girls would be like, you young.
You young.
So, yeah, I started lying
but you was the one
age,
that
right?
was part
Oh, oh man, God. I used to lie about my
so
age.
So did you? Did they get you? Did they want you because
age.
You lied?
Yeah, no. I mean, well, yeah, they did. But okay. I lied about my age so much, I forgot how old I was.
You know what? That's real sad.
It is.
That's real, real sad, Jack.
And I had fake IDs, and I told you, it was 18 of us on the street. So everybody would give me an ID, an old license that they had, and I would use them. Yeah.
You can't get away with that.
I was in a Mirage at 16. 17. I was in a Mirage at 17.
Really?
Yep. I posted up. Like I'm somebody.
I ain't gonna lie. I was too. I was at Bell's till next
Bell's
day.
Bell's on the
My
circle.
My mom, aunt used to be like, if you don't get your ass in here at 12, you can't get in. I used to be like, okay.
Oh, and check this out. Guess okay. what else I got into? Hmm. The Reason.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
oh,
I was in The Reason.
Well, you know, I used to rap, so I knew all the DJs and stuff, so I ain't had no problem.
You got
getting
bars?
I got bars. I got little bars. I'm 46, so that's, you know.
I got a rap by my, me and my homeboy.
You gonna bust it for me?
Lyrical Menace, bro.
Oh, yeah. Really? Yeah. I think he, No, it might not be him. I might have the name wrong. But go ahead and bust it for me then. Okay. Let me hear it. You know your voice is so hot, so I know you sound good.
You gotta be my backup. So the name of the song is called Phone Hoes.
What? How gonna be? I'm your girlfriend right now. I ain't your hoe.
All right? No. You gotta do the hook.
Okay, what's
and
the
hook? And the hook is Phone Hoes. Keep calling my name.
That's what you want me to do?
Yeah.
Okay,
that's
you ready?
Right.
I'm going to have fun with you. Right. Are you ready?
Friday night at 2 a.m. I was woke up by the phone. Some bitch's voice said softly, I'm surprised you at home. But check it, give me your name so I know who I'm talking to. Oh, you don't know my voice? How many bitches be calling you? Don't worry about it. You call my house, but you won't. Ho, and giving it up to want to see me. My ass has got to go. She said, well, all that's cool. But nigga, you ain't got a front for 30 days of the month. You couldn't handle this gun. Look, bitch, don't make a problem before my attitude change. If I don't even know your name. Matter of fact, I should hang up. I don't get my phone numbers. The hoes that like to play games, you know. I wised up and hit the click on the hoe because say she ain't acting right or say she ain't down the bone. Best believe that she could talk to the dial tone.
I can't say that.
Audition girls to do the hook. Phone hoes. Keep calling.
We gotta clean that rap up.
We gotta do the edit, but now you gotta understand. This is 9th and 10th grade. This is where our heads was.
You can rap
at
like
that.
And your mama heard that.
I don't know.
But I know she did.
Absolutely. We were sneaking. You know, listening to Ghetto Boys and DJ Quick and Eazy-E. Our minds was gone. Born and raised in Compton. Come on.
That's hot.
All right.
So you worked these jobs.
Right.
After
five.
In this world, what did you decide to do with yourself first? Or did you... You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, okay. So my first thing was that education, I rules the nation. Mm-hmm. So I always had a knack for making a difference in young people's lives.
Okay.
So young people's lives, I always had a knack for that. So what I did was I started to go ahead and get involved in the education after I graduated from college. So yeah, so what I did was is I started tutoring, teaching kids, and then I got into special ed. So I did special ed for 10 years.
What was your degree in college?
Communications and public relations.
Well, that's hot. Right.
So that's why I'm a natural.
Don't you want to be on the show? And you want to do some commercials with me or something?
Absolutely.
I'm going to definitely utilize you.
Absolutely. I would love to do
a
commercial.
I like to utilize people.
But, hey, use me up, as Aaron Neville would say.
Okay.
Come on, baby.
So that's a good field you went in. Now, what made you interested in the kids? Did something happen? Is it because you felt you didn't have that and you want to make sure any other child had like?
From a young age, I always like little kids. Because you know what? A younger kid, they're so honest. Like, people, men lie, women lie every single day. But kids are brutally honest. They are honest and they are straightforward. And that's something I always liked about kids.
Mm-hmm. That's true. You ask a kid something, they're going to tell you everything. Mm-hmm. Mommy went over there with that man.
Coach for the Bedford Bearcats, and I coach for my son's baseball team as well. But kids they'll go the extra mile, even in education and sports. Yeah, they'll go ahead and give you their all, and that's just a genuine thing. I always like that.
Yes, they will. Oh yeah, my little Bray Bray comb my weave for me because he see me combing my weave. You know what I'm saying? He's like, "Gigi." I'm like, "Oh, God." But it's so cute. Right. I get it. So so you got it. That's hot, though, that you became an educator. That is hot.
Yep.
So you became an educator.
Yep.
How long have you been coaching and teaching?
So let's see. I got in grad school since 2002.
Oh, that's a good while.
2003, yep.
That's a good while. Yep, so that know the kids love you.
Yeah, I mean, I'm loved by all.
Yeah, I know. Anyway. We got like 10 more minutes for the camera to work.
You asked me, it's been a minute.
I know. It's okay. This is real talk. We all good. It's all good. So, you've been teaching these kids. That is awesome. Like, how did you get into the wine?
Okay, so my homeboy was making wine.
Okay.
And I started making wine.
Okay.
And we met one time and we just said, let's bring it together and do this together.
That's
and that's what we did. So it's been. We went together and did this and it's just been beautiful.
It's been beautiful.
Yeah,
but really that's hot, two hot men own a business and want to start. Wine is the thing for the ladies.
And look just how we've been blessed. I mean, we've been blessed beyond success. So, and then that's another thing. Success is what you make it.
Thank you. It's not what society tells you, it's what makes you happy.
Right, exactly. Mm-hmm. What's success? What's your definition of success? Because if you have everything you have, you're successful. But I said that to say, we've been blessed with the tasting room. And now we're opening our second location.
Where?
Yes, in Garfield Heights. So weekend. It's gonna be a lounge. So it's not gonna be like the tasting room. Tasting room come in, it's gonna be totally different. We still have the tasting room. And it's gonna be upscale. It's gonna be gonna be a VIP. Members only.
Oh, I know.
Platinum member or gold member? Because that's the two things we want to have. Platinum.
Platinum
is better, right?
I know. I ain't
stupid. Platinum or gold member. Yeah, it's going to be members only.
I'm going to check that out. I will get involved because I believe in that support in the communities.
And then I'm going to have something for the fellas. We're going to have something for the fellas. It's going to be Fridays and then something for that. So I was thinking about something which since now grown man groove with the cigars and the bourbon and nothing but ties and suit jackets, you know,
we come in there right. So another thing, what kind of things in the community do you get involved with your business? That's very important also.
Absolutely.
What you put back into the community is what you get back.
You doggone right. So, and that's one entity that goes into the Hudson Foundation. Mm-hmm. The Hudson Foundation is MAD. So the MAD means making a difference.
Gotcha.
And the making a difference is getting these kids. I mean, see, this is my thing. My thing is, if you surround people, I'm about to show this picture.
Okay.
But if you surround people with like-minded people, then you won't have anything to go astray. Yeah. So if you get these kids together and they all practicing what they preach and everybody's getting good grades and everybody has something to look out for, then it makes... That's we just went to the movies. That's part of
my fantastic
see.
Focus on that. I'll share it.
Exactly.
So you teamed up and it's called Hudson Foundation.
The Hudson Foundation is MAD. You can go on Facebook page right there. And the MAD means making a difference. Business, I kind of slacked up, but then I made it my mission. I said, regardless of what I have going on, I gotta stay on it. Yeah, and these kids, I mean, it's just good to see them smile. It's good to see them in a safe place. And I also do something with them called Verses and Flows. I usually have a speaker come in, and then we talk, we break down
about
raps.
That. I didn't know that was you. Verses and Flows.
Yeah, we do Verses and Flows at my meeting.
Okay.
Yep. And what we do is we break down a rap song. You know, you should have seen
them.
Oh, man. Hey, they was absorbing. Then I played a song afterwards.
And then they be shocked at what it was made of. Right.
Well, the thing is that hip-hop is poetry. These rappers and stuff, some of them are genius. Now, yes. A lot of these new school dudes, I don't know.
I'm sorry. But, the rap where they don't even finish the full words and it's four letters in the word, that's not a rap.
Right.
They don't even say here. They say that. What's that?
Right. But I mean, like we broke it down. You should have seen their minds opening. I'm a big stickler about this. Reading, writing, and math. I mean, they don't even think about it now. In school, they don't even teach handwriting.
They don't. You know,
like, how the heck don't you know how to do cursive? And you in the eighth grade.
You know, like, they're talking about not teaching cursive. Faithfully.
Yes.
Like, I'm in data analyst, pricing analyst specialist for Hinkle.
Okay.
Daily.
It's a shame that they don't even teach handwriting or the basic concepts of math anymore. It's like you gotta, like, what worked back in the day still works. I mean, 1 + 1 still equals 2, and it ain't gonna change.
You know how many times I've seen on or at a cashier at a Walmart at a store or something, if the receipt thing broke, they didn't know how to give you no change.
Thank you.
What the hell?
I just went through that.
You don't know how to add up a change?
I was at and like I said, I'm all about supporting our people. I really am. But I was at an establishment. And her, like you said, the register went down, and this young lady did not know. She did not know how to take $20 from. I mean, I gave her $20. So I said. I said, it's 15-19 or 15-18. I said, just round up. That's all you got to do.
Yep.
She was like, huh? I said, just round up. Take them 2 pennies, up to 20. Mm-hmm. And then I said, then go from there. She was like, oh. Mm-hmm. Right. I'm like, she still didn't wow.
Oh, you had to give her the number.
And even going back, that's even
481.
That's even going back to my
give me $4
going to my going back to the educational aspect of special ed, that they're just putting these kids through special ed. Nobody's learning anything. Read then or write then or add. So it's just sad. It's
in the educational process, in these student board meetings, and explain to them, we want this type of class for our kids. We want, if you don't say anything, they do what the hell they want to do. So you need to go to meet for your kids' school.
You doggone right.
I was at my daughter's school.
Right,
you know what I'm saying?
Right.
So I get
that. That means a lot to us.
No, that's very true. So, where you plan on taking your education and stuff? What do you plan on doing with this? How are you feeling in the community for everybody that's watching?
Right. So the first thing is grant writing. So I want to write a grant because, see, this is the other thing. Mm-hmm. Other thing is, these kids need a place to go to feel safe and to burn off a lot of that testosterone and energy. Mm-hmm. Girls as well as guys. That's why I don't limit my foundation to just one sex. I want and like you said, you got all these racing hormones and everything. So the first thing basketball, we can sit down and talk.
We can burn that off.
Yeah. One of my I'm not gonna even say hopefully, whatever God sees fit, right?
Exactly. Because it'll be bigger than what you imagine.
That's what I'm talking about.
This just started as a talk show for me.
Yep.
When I was paying someone else to be on their station, I realized I can have my own station. It grows. So this might be bigger than what you think.
Absolutely.
We need to talk, though, because I'm kind of in that stage.
Okay.
I'm in that stage because music was my thing.
Right.
So this can really grow into something major, teaching them business, music production, commercial, entrepreneurship.
Yep.
And radio.
Even to the fact that we didn't even know, we were just ignorant to the fact, we didn't know.
I went to Twinsburg schools.
Oh, okay.
They taught us Toastmasters in the fifth grade. Toastmasters is a speaking class.
Oh.
Like, I could stand in front of a lot of people, organize a speech, depending on what I'm talking about.
But we weren't taught that yet.
When I came to Cleveland schools, I graduated in 8 months because I had all the...
right, all the credits, yeah.
We can control that, though.
Yeah,
us as adults and people...
Exactly.
You have to say something.
Why don't we teach the importance of credit to these young kids that's going out into the workforce and the college?
Yep.
Like nobody has an idea of what credit really is.
Our school system is teaching our kids. Absolutely. We have to go to so real on that. We'll be here all night.
Oh, yeah.
But anyway.
I mean,
I'm real on that.
We might be anyway.
Yeah, you broke up. We both free. So, that's how.
For real, though, like, seriously, that's where it starts at. It starts with people getting involved into these young kids and not just thinking, or teachers not just coming for a check, or people not just having a school,
these
or one of these
really
charter schools.
Care.
Yeah, some of them. Not all of them.
That's like the police. Half of them care and
half of them don't. Right.
Mm-hmm.
It just depends. So it takes another strong entity in the backbone to say, hey, we care about these kids. We want to get them something else. Mm-hmm. And you can leave and look right now. How many open gyms is it now?
It ain't no more.
Right.
We used to go to all that stuff.
Yes, and that's
why
we
do have that control, and we need to implement that back
absolutely.
In our communities for people to come take charge.
Yep,
you complain
right.
about who the president and what he's trying to do. What are you doing?
I agree.
Stop it. Most of our black people, this is my opinion, are hurting themselves.
Well, during this last presidential election, and I don't want to get too political.
They didn't want to vote.
Three million black people didn't vote. They voted in a in the primary for Obama. I mean, that's ridiculous. But yet, we're talking about, oh yeah, we want change.
You know what I'm saying? You took, and you were honest with me today. I feel like you were honest.
Oh, I ain't nothing but honest. Why would I lie?
I'm just saying, you know, come on now. Folks, I'll be sitting here like, wow.
Alrighty,
this show is over. No, I'm just playing. But that's how
cancel.
We went a good little long while. That is hot and it's good to. And go, man, he cool.
Right.
Much love and respect. You know
exactly.
what I'm saying?
Yes,
that's important.
Because like that.
People get the wrong impressions of people.
Mm-hmm.
I had Prem DiBiase in here last night. You know what that is?
Yeah.
It's a rapper.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
People look at thug rappers as these little dumb little...
Right.
That boy's smart.
Yep.
He has never worked for anyone else. Yes, I learned a lot about him last night, so that's hot. People can see that.
Exactly.
Yeah, he's just rapper, he write everything, but that boy is smart.
Right.
He ain't signed with no label, he run his own stuff.
Yeah, and that's what everybody that's involved with Lina Wines, everybody has had higher education. So it's like when we all get together, that's why this...
be there. I want to film. Like, we definitely got to schedule a wine making process. We're gonna make my wine. I'm gonna pay for the session, and we're gonna film it. With you, so I can say Lina Wines all damn day.
Absolutely,
Lina Wines,
yeah, Lina
Wines,
right?
You know that's
come
hot.
Come get you some
so,
wine.
Here, let me make sure everybody see this. Lina Wines, what I done? Hold on.
I don't know. I think you got to tap the top part. No. Leroy, Maple Heights, Ohio, 44137. Come by Lina Wines Tasting Room Thursday, Friday, or Saturday, or Sunday through Wednesday by appointment.
Okay.
Give us a call. We'll meet you up there. Gladly discuss anything that you want to discuss. All of our wines are made right there at the tasting room.
That's hot.
You can come by. You can have a party. You can reserve the spot. I mean, we had so many people come by. I do want to say that we thank all of our friends. As I don't call y'all customers, I call y'all friends. Because everybody that comes by is like a family member or something. They just come by and feel comfortable. So we really appreciate that.
That's
and
right.
It's because of you guys that we're able and we're exactly. put in a position to open the second
it's
spot.
It's the people.
So, thank you. Yep.
It's the people and all
and
those.
People like DJ Squizzard.
Hey, baby.
Right.
And I'm trying to make something, you know what I'm saying? I pay for all this. I'm not making any money yet.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really not about the money. This
right.
is about the love I have for
I love that you said that because so much emphasis is based on money. Yep, but no, money and about what money brings. You know, sometimes you have to step outside your comfort.
Now,
craft.
But yep. I'm working this because I know the business. I got to make numbers first. You know what I'm saying? I got to show productivity in order to go, hey, I'm worth this amount of money.
Right.
People think you're just supposed to hand them an amount of money and they ain't showed you nothing.
Yeah, right.
No, baby.
No results, right?
This is productivity right mm-hmm. here. I works this.
All right.
So I'm glad you took the time out to come.
Right.
You know, I went through a lot in my life, and I'm finally to a point where, you know, yeah, I'm single now, I hang out, I have a good time. I want to make a difference, as you say, in our communities and in this world. I don't want to just be another person to come live here.
Guess what? Let's do this. I told you I'm a man of my word. I told you when we was in the Blue Breeze.
I know you was busy. I was like, if this man, I don't make flyers no more than nothing unless you tell me you coming.
Hey, we was at the Blue Breeze. I told you, I do your show. I said, we did. And, shout out to
Blue Breeze. Yeah,
Deke, at the Blue Breeze.
We got to get him in here.
He has nothing but bottle.
When I was there, she poured. I was drinking.
What was it? The redhead?
Yes, that's
watermelon
what it was.
White Merlot.
Yes, it was.
Yeah.
It was so
but
good.
He keeps us in rotation like clockwork.
That's hot.
Every couple of weeks,
that's hot.
He comes and get cases. So I appreciate you, bro.
That's hot.
Appreciate everybody that supports. We're in Black Box Fix. We're in Red Wine and Brew. We're in various locations. So, you know, that's too many for me to name.
That's
but
hot.
We appreciate all of the love. I really, really, really
Black
do
on
appreciate
wine,
it.
That is so hot. I was so happy to post that. But I was like, I didn't want to post that y'all was coming that you don't come. I knew you was busy. I'm like, I done called you three times.
I'm coming. I said, I made sure that I had my day set and I was coming.
That's hot.
Yeah,
I appreciate it.
Absolutely.
Now,
this is what I was about to say.
Go ahead. I'm
before,
sorry.
Okay.
We've been sipping a little bit.
Yeah,
go ahead.
Right.
We brought back a great
Yeah,
show.
Right. But good this would be friend. Good for the kids in my foundation to come up here and see how this. Let's do that.
Let me tell you what I got planned.
Okay. Let's hear.
Miss Jacqueline Black from East Tech High School.
Okay.
We are rounding up children. Do you remember Teen Summit?
Yes, Teen Summit.
A regular weekly or bi-weekly show with real children in here.
Oh, man, that'd be
She is the director of Philly Wheaton's play, Soulmate.
Okay.
She's the stage director.
Oh, cool.
So she can handle these kids. She's a teacher also at East.
Yeah, I went to a game. See, my younger cousin goes to John Hay, and I went to go see him play.
You need to speak to her about speaking to her kids.
Yeah,
the love like you spoke to me.
And
I
absolutely.
Went and spoke to her kids. It was wonderful.
See, that's what it's about.
They received us well.
Every day I'm networking. Well, every day.
I'm going to hit her up and send her your name and information.
Okay.
So that she can communicate with you to come in and talk to her kids.
Absolutely.
Also, since you have those children and she has children, we can incorporate all these children.
Yeah, bring them
into
up here. Let's
every
talk.
Week we have different kids where we can participate. I wanted them here in the studio, but, you know, East Tech, a lot of them, that's going to be a transportation problem.
Mm-hmm.
We were thinking about going to East Tech.
Okay. Hey.
Well, we can rotate that. I can
go
to your school.
My word is bond. We can set up
Let's do
here.
That.
And have my kids from my foundation come here.
Let's do
we
that.
We can go there. We can go wherever. It doesn't matter.
Well, we're going to talk because I would love, it's very important. Like, again, we're global. I got people in Serbia, Germany, Paris.
That's big.
That communicate with me. Like we're talking now.
Yeah.
A couple days I get an email like, now, who is that gentleman and what is he doing?
Right, right.
Somebody in Serbia.
That's
email.
Good.
So I'm saying I'm doing what I set out to do, which is to communicate all over the here on a weekly, we can try to organize the conversations.
Absolutely.
And
let these kids know
yes,
that we care.
And give them that platform where they can express themselves.
Absolutely.
That is amazing.
Yeah.
So we'll talk about that.
Absolutely.
I do got to hit up Miss Jackie Black also. So. A soap opera. Radio soap opera.
I like.
You have a voice.
And I definitely.
I'll keep you posted on what's and we're going, she's going to do casting.
Okay.
So I would love for you to come out, maybe, you know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
I'm letting her do her thing.
Okay.
But we're going to do this platform here. Right. And when she has casting, I'm going to let you know.
Gotcha.
That's going to be hot.
Oh, so, that'll be perfect. I would love to do it.
I have a lot in my mind that I want to do, but I can only do one thing at a time.
Absolutely.
I don't know everything. So mm-hmm. I got to let people that's professionals be the professionals.
Exactly.
Okay? But, you know, I know what I know.
Well, that's the thing. The thing is that it's true that a mind is a terrible thing to waste. So once you have that format in your head mm-hmm. and all your ideas come.
Oh, I works it.
Yeah. You just keep them going. Yeah.
As you see. So, I appreciate you taking out time again. I'll see you out again, boo.
You already know.
Where you going tonight?
That's a good question. I'm watching the cat. What's up with the Cavs game?
You know. I need sports people. But anyway, go ahead and give them your plugs. Give them your information about Lina Wines before okay. we shut this down.
All right. Once again, visit Lina Wines Tasting Room. 520. You can also hit us up at any time you want. Thursday, Friday, you can come in. Samples are only 50 cents.
That's hot.
And you can take it home. Exactly.
Yeah, well, we need to schedule me coming to make my little
spot. Right. Wine. And it's a great gift, too. We have a lot of people who don't even drink wine. Mm-hmm. Who come in there and buy wine as a gift.
Yeah, that's a gift. Yep. That's hot. Well, we definitely got to get that scheduled.
Absolutely.
Get that camera in there.
Absolutely.
And I want to thank you again for coming by.
No problem.
And for being my man.
Shout out to all the entrepreneurs out
that's
here.
That's right. Working.
That's doing their thing.
That's right.
That constantly stay on the hustle because you have to do that and believe in yourself. Put God first, family comes second, and everything else is third.
Okay. If you don't believe in something, you
right.
Exactly. Oh baby, you like a pinball in a pinball game. You just ping just hitting everything.
Right. And thank you, DJ Squirt.
You're welcome, bro.
I love what you're doing. Like
thank
I said,
you.
It's all about doing what you're passionate about doing.
Music. I love everybody. Yep. You got to see me. I'm here. You know what I'm saying? I'm loud. And I believe in bringing people together. And the purpose is just for people all over the world to see everybody over the world. So we are controlled by the media. And you can learn and understand and respect people. They do. And it helps them and it helps you.
Absolutely.
It's therapy.
Absolutely.
All right, y'all. Me and my man Squirt. About to go. I don't know what we're going to do when we cut this camera off. But thank you for tuning in.
Peace.
And I guess, you know, check in with your wife later. I don't know.
All right.
I don't know. We'll see. All right. Thank you again. You guys tune in to UrbanCityRadioStation.com. Download that Urban City Radio Station app. And be sure to tune in. We are available on Facebook. Facebook as UrbanCityRadioStation.com. We're on Instagram at Urban City Radio Station. We are also on Twitter at UCR Station. And we will be
started from.
Yeah, we drank that. We drank that little wine. Hey now. But
also go to LinaWines.com too.
Hey now. So LinaWines.com.
Yeah, LinaWines.com.
Yeah, make sure. Baby. Thank you for coming in. All right, you guys, have a good night.